Kids Health presents How the Body Works with Chloe and the Nerve.
The tibia's connected to the femur. The femur's connected to the ilium. Oh, hello there, Chloe.
Nerb, where are you?
I'm the gelatinous blob lying on this rock.
Oh. Nerb, where are your bones?
Being cleaned, of course. Once a year, we nerbs send our bones out for some serious scrubbing. And today's my bone cleaning day. Well, technically, yesterday was my bone cleaning day. The cleaning service temporarily misplaced my bones. At least they found my skull! The fibula's connected to the tibia.
I wish I could help you, but I don't know anything about bones.
Oh. Don't know about bones. Don't know about bones! Do you like to talk? Eat? Swim? Dance? Like my dance?
It's great. And yes, I like all those things.
Then you need to know about bones. Or as they are known to fancy people, the skeletal system. And there's only one place for us to go to learn about the bones. The Boneyard.
As creepy and awesome as that sounds, how are you going anywhere?
Simple. Strap me on like a backpack.
I should have known. All right, Jelly Nerb, let's do this thing.
Bone lesson number one. The bones have three main jobs. They allow your body to move, they protect your delicate vital organs, and they produce blood cells in bone marrow.
Speaking of moving, I have to say you are surprisingly comfortable to wear.
Why, thank you, Chloe. I get that a lot. Bone lesson number two. Bones are made of calcium, and when you consume calcium-rich foods, like milk, your bones are very happy things.
Ooh, Nerb, look!
The Boneyard.
Well, this isn't exactly what I expected.
I told you! Bones are happy things! Rest me on that lovely rock over there, and I'll teach you about bones and help you through the skeleton building process.
The what building process?
We're here to build me a temporary skeleton, of course.
That sounds surprisingly fun. Direct away.
Great attitude, Chloe. High five. Oh, take this blueprint and off you go. And don't worry, it only takes 206 bones to make a skeleton.
Challenge accepted.
Now, there are two different kinds of bones. There are axial bones that keep you upright, like ribs in the spine, and appendicular bones that help you move, like the bones of your arms and legs.
Axial and appendicular.
Correct. And that thing that lets the leg move back and forth is a joint. Joints connect bones to help them move. That one's a knee joint.
Whoa, Nerb, what's this bone? It's tiny.
That, my dear Chloe, is one of the ossicles. There are three of them in your middle ear, and they're the smallest bones in your body.
So I have to find two more? Game on!
Chloe, if I could applaud your adventurous spirit right now, I would. But unfortunately, there are no bones in my hands.
Ooh, this one's got a crack in it.
That is called a fracture. Bones fracture, or break, all kinds of ways. Sometimes they're very small breaks, like hairline fractures. But sometimes the fracture can be more serious.
Yikes!
Don't worry. Bones are living things, and they fix themselves pretty quickly. New bone cells grow on the broken ends to fuse the two parts together again. Sometimes you need a cast to keep the pieces of the bone in place so they grow back correctly.
I think this baby is done. How does it look?
Oh, Chloe, it's beautiful.
Try it on. Wow, you look great.
You think so? I've never been so tall. It might be a little hard to walk.
I think I may have an idea.
The ilium's connected to the spinal column. The spinal column's connected to the rib bones. The rib bones.